Okay, it's back to the surgeon. I had a few days off, and I haven't thought too much about this painting, but now that I look at it, the first thing I want to do is I want to do some more work on the face. I don't think I'm going to finish it today. I'd love to finish it today, but I don't think I'm going to. I just want to go over the face one more time, put some shadows in, punch up some highlights, work on some of the details, try and get that under control. Then the next thing, I think, I'm not real happy. I like the color of the outfit, you know, the gown, whatever it's called, but I'm not sure it really works with the rest of the painting, so I may have to change that. I'm thinking about changing that, but I don't know what I want to change it to. That's the only problem. And then, but I like the drawing. I think the drawing's good, you know. So if I can get the face a little more, put a little more energy into the face, let me put it that way, and then figure out what kind of color I want to use for the gown, then the rest would be pretty routine, I think. So, all right, so let's do the face. I'm gonna put in, I'm gonna apply some glaze and then rub it out, get some highlights, some shadows, etc. And I think for the glaze, I'm going to use the cerulean blue and cadmium red with a little bit of thinner in it. And we'll see what happens. Oh man, light. That should be good. All right, now for the, I put some cadmium red on there. I also have to punch up the hands, but I'll do that later. I don't want to start moving the camera around, because sometimes when I start moving the camera around, I forget to move it back to where it's supposed to be. I don't know, I might have too much red in there. We'll see. Also, I'm using a new brush. You know, I've been using these synthetic brushes, synthetic bristle. For years, I used natural bristle, the hog bristle, but at some point I switched to the synthetic. This is a number 8 filbert, but this is a natural bristle because my synthetic one is kind of worn out and I have to get another new one, but I don't have it yet. So I'm going to go back to the bristle for this one. We'll see what happens, you know. Well, I need some paint too, so I'll place my usual $60 order of supplies to Jerry's Artorama. You have to spend more than $50 to get free shipping, you know, so. But that's never hard to do at the art supply store, to spend more than $50. Unlike writing, all you need is a pencil and a piece of paper. I've told that story before of Helmut Newton, the photographer who was noted for his photographs of naked women, most of them about 6'4", wearing 9-inch heels and dressed in these, how would you describe it, very fetching poses. But he was well known. I think he died a few years ago. But he traveled the world doing these photo spreads for Vogue and various fashion magazines. And he was really great. But one time, Esquire magazine interviewed him, and they said, they talked about his career, this and that. And then finally the interviewer said, "Well, Helmut, if you had it to do over and you weren't a photographer, what would you want to be?" And Newton says, "I'd like to be a writer." He said, "All you need is a pencil, a piece of paper, and your mind." He said, "That's the ultimate." And I'm reading this, I'm saying, is this, this guy needs his head examined, basically. Yeah, I love that story. Not too bad, actually. Not too bad. I need a smaller brush for in here. See, now this area right here, the philtrum, that's scooped out area under the nose. The shadow, see, the light source is coming from his right. It's coming from that direction. So this side of the face is going to be in shadow because the nose is going to block out some of the light. So there's going to be, this should actually be more in shadow here. There'll always be a highlight here because of his cheekbone. Likewise with the philtrum, this side of the philtrum right here is going to have a little highlight. But that's not what I had in mind. See, now this side over here on his right is going to be kind of dark. And then the shadow, so what I have to do is, this is not a big deal. I could just, you know, put a single brush stroke right down the middle and that would be fine. But see if I can put a little shadow on that side, see? And then this brush is actually a little too big for this, but then just a little bit of punch it up over here, and it gives it that scooped out look, you know, which I have not achieved, but that's a little bit better. But it's too gray. There has to be more red in here. Well, what I have to do probably is just rub this out. I didn't have any red in there to begin with, so I'll put some red kind of on this side, just on that side, okay? This brush, let me get a smaller brush for this. I should probably also have something to brace my hand, you know, like sometimes I'll put a stick across here to brace my hand, like, yeah, okay, I'll do that now. Now I have more control over the stroke. It sucks, really. I may have to give up on that, I don't know. Well, I'll put the, once I put the drawing in, that may help. We'll see. I could put the highlight in, like right now. I'll put a highlight in there. Okay. Then I'll put the draw, then I'll draw it, let it dry, then come back with the shadow on that side. That's the best way to do it. Right now it looks totally lame. It's too big. The philtrum is too big and it's too much over on the left side of his face, but I can fix that. But when you get that effect, it looks pretty cool. I could show you one painting that it came out really great, but I don't know. All right, so let's continue with this. I need to put in some more highlights here. Oops. Yeah, I kind of overdid it there, but looks good actually. That looks good. That's what you want. You know, you want some contrast between the highlights and the shadows. And if you get too much, you can always tone it down, you know. That looks good up there though. Then I need more here too, that cheekbone, you know. Yeah, face is coming along. It's coming along. Starting to look like a painting, actually. Know what I mean? It's starting to look like a painting. It's It's always nice to get a highlight right along the bridge of the nose, see if I can do it. You know, get that line in there, that always looks good. Plus the nostril usually has something. It's starting to look pretty good. Nice. Mouth looks good. All right, now I'll do the hands. The one hand. Put some glaze down there. I put the cerulean blue and the red cadmium red light glaze. And then the arm. Yeah, it takes a little bit getting used to going back to the bristle type brush. It's a different, you have to apply a different kind of pressure. You just have to acquire a certain feeling, whatever kind of brush you're using. There's a certain feeling you have to acquire to use it properly, and it, you know, that takes time, of course, but so this needs be punched up a little, yeah, more like that. Well, it might be all right once I draw it. It looks a little smeared right now, but I think once I draw it, it'll look better. All right, so what to do about this color for the shirt, for the gown. I like this color, but somehow I don't even remember what it was. I think it was, I don't remember, was it emerald green with some ultramarine blue? I could try that with a little bit of white, I think. Let me try it, see what I get. I was also thinking of purple. You know, I was thinking of, I'm usually not too successful with purple or violet, but I was thinking that might work for the gown. I'm gonna try that, actually. I have some, a tube that I've never, I have a tube of, what is it? Permanent Mauve, M-A-U-V-E, that I bought about 9 years ago, and I think I've used it twice, so. Maybe this is the time to reintroduce that one. All right, I'll scrub some of that in there. It's a beautiful color. I mean, you know, it's a beautiful color, but you still have to make it work. I told a story about Picasso. Picasso didn't have that problem because he was Picasso. He said, I put into my paintings the colors I like, and I leave it for the colors to work things out with each other. And then Matisse heard that one. He didn't appreciate that comment too much because he was known for having a great sense of color, Matisse. And he said about Picasso, he said, Pablo was a very great painter. He's a very, very great painter. It's too bad he has no palette. Yeah, I told that other story about they were friends. They had a great rivalry going, but they were friends and they lived near each other at one point in the south of France. And Picasso was going to pay a visit to Matisse, and he was with his girlfriend. I think it was François Gillot at the time. And they were about to go over to see Matisse, and Picasso said, wear green and purple, your outfit. Mix it up, a combination of green and purple, because those are two of his favorite colors. I like that story. Well, now, what's gonna happen? I have to rub it out and throw some white in there. I mean, what's the color of a surgeon's? It's usually some sort of pastel green, I think, but Mickey Roarke, you know, he gets to call his own shots, wardrobe-wise, you know what I'm saying? All right, so let's see what happens when I put some white in here. I mean, the color itself can be good, but does it work with the painting? Does it work with the rest of the painting, you know? That's always the issue. It might work. This might work, actually. Depends what I do with the background, you know? Or I could adopt the attitude of Picasso and just say, you know, I'm going to let the colors fight it out with each other. Does it work? I don't know. I'm not sure. But I like the color. I like this color. I'm going to use this color. And the other colors can, we'll have to live with it. That's all. They'll have to learn how to live with the purple. But can I live with it? That's the... Well, it depends on what I do up here. Also, there's no purple or even white in the face. That can sometimes be a problem. It usually helps if whatever pigments you've got in this color, at least one of them, maybe, not a bad idea, should appear over here. And then there's some sort of complementary effect occurring, you know, or compatible effect, I should say, occurring. But right now, there's no purple or white in that face. Hard to say. Well, so for this, well, I'll try the old ultramarine blue, raw sienna, and white. And I use that a lot for my background, so it's kind of a neutral. I don't know, we'll see. We'll just have to try it, see how it goes. It's a dark green. That was actually, man, it's really dark. Well, that might work though. I don't know, we'll see. That was actually the color of his shirt originally. Something like. And it's got a lot of blue in it. Too much blue, maybe. It's a nice color. I'm gonna get rid of the hat. That's not gonna work. I can see that right now. You know, this needs more white. Let me do this. This needs more white though. Actually, what I could do is I could mix the ultramarine blue with the purple, the mauve, and then the white. That might help. Well, let me do this first. All right, so now I have to rub this out. Put in some white. Okay, so that's not too bad. I don't know. Might need a little bit more white, but I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna put a little ultramarine blue into. Of course, I didn't have that upper part of the canvas in frame, but all right. So I'll put a little ultramarine blue in here, and then some white, and see what we get. Mud is what we get is mud, because I think I still got too much raw sienna on my brush. And it's better. Yeah, you have to be careful. If you mix more than three paints together, you're gonna have a problem. You're gonna get mud. Usually three is going to be okay. But more than that, you start mixing too many colors together, or if you leave too much paint on something before you add more paint, it can get muddy on you. Right now, I don't know. We'll have to see what happens when I put the white in, because right now it's looking really... not a nice color, very dull color, but the white might change that. We'll see what happens. I'll rub some of it out. No, I don't know. It'd be okay. It's not a real vibrant color, but that's okay, because his outfit is not the focal or the focus of the painting. His face and the saw is where you want to draw the attention of the viewer, you know? So this could be good. The color isn't bad. It's pastel-y. Kind of pastel-y. You know, I like it. I think it works. I think it looks good. I think I need more white in the background, but this is a nice color. So it's the ultramarine blue and the mauve and the white. Okay, now I'm gonna put some more white in the background. I think that's what the background needs. And remember to raise the camera. Nice, I remember to raise the camera. The most important thing. You know, not bad, not bad. Now I have to repaint this little saw, and I don't know what color I want to make this. A neutral, some sort of, oh, I know what. I'll make it, I'll use white, black, and yellow ochre, kind of a light green. I think that'll look good, yeah. Will it? I don't know. Maybe a little more white. Then there's the handle is right here. Yeah, it looks all right. And for the blade, a black and Naples yellow and maybe some white. It gives it a gray. I need more white. Yeah, that's, that might be all right. Okay, now I have to do some drawing. I start with the face. Make the glasses a little brighter. Just putting some yellow ochre there. Well, there's some little discrepancies here and there, you know, but after this dries, I have to go over it again anyway. I can fix those. I don't want to try and do it now because the paint's wet. But I think the mouth looks good. This is too much. There's too much of a line there, but I can fix that. Then the eyebrow. That looks all right. And the hairline. And then the eyeglass. I gotta put in that part of the rim too. I'll wait till it dries before I do that. Yeah, some little touch up here and there, but after it dries, I can do that. That looks good though. All right, and then now I got to redraw all this other stuff. Oh, you know what? I got to put some white in for the mask. The mask needs some white. And then there's that little, what is this called? The little strap. All right, now for the fingers. I forgot, I gotta put some paint in this for his fingernail. Also this one. Then this blade, what does it look like? It looks like it's got to look a little frightening, I know that. Is that good? Yeah, it looks all right. You know what it is, it's a blade. All right, the arm. All right, so I think that's as much as I can really do today. I have to wait till it dries, and when, but I think the colors really look good. I think the shirt is good. I have to come back, do a little touch up around there. This line of the, this black line here doesn't look real great. Fix that. Put that little, and most important, don't forget the cigarette. That'll be the last thing. I'll have to wait till the mouth is completely dry before I put that cigarette in there. But and then a few little, I have to fill in some areas that are spotty around here and there. But so I can do that right now with the there's a certain effect you can get when you go along the outline with a small brush, very close, and press a little firmly and get a very clean line right down and up here too. I'm pressing hard against the left edge of the brush. and it cleans up that line, gives you a very sharp line there. I mean, you follow the drawing, you're following the drawing, but you're just, and then like on the other side, and it's hard for me to reach over, but, you know, same thing. But that's one of the last things you do. Also, up here, I have to get some paint up here. Yeah, see, I'll do the same thing up here. I'll press hard against it and make a very crisp line. That always looks good. Well, Mickey Roarke is the surgeon. Looks pretty good. There he is. Mr. Cool. Before he had all the plastic surgery. I mean, what happened? Why did he have all that plastic surgery? Because at some point, when he was a superstar, he decided, this is a story that I read that's somewhere, maybe you've heard it. He decided that acting wasn't a very manly profession. I think he had done some boxing when he was younger. He thought that acting was a little unmanly, and he decided to go back into the ring. So he started training. Then he started fighting, had a few fights. I think he won a few fights. Of course, he lost a few. But during the process, his face got a little bit rearranged, let's say, and he decided to have some plastic surgery done. Well, once they start that plastic surgery, they don't know when to stop. You know, I think it becomes some sort of an addiction or something. And the next thing you know, you start doing that plastic surgery, you have this done, you have that done, you have the other thing done, and the next thing you know, you look like you grew up on Mars or something, you know? So Mickey no longer, well, of course, now he's 65 years old, so, you know, but he was too cool. What can I tell you? All right, so that's it. Also, you know what? I just noticed something. I don't like the way those eyebrows are. I think those have to be drawn some better. I have to draw them kind of like that. I'll have to repaint those anyways, the same color as the hair, you know. But I can do that. Otherwise, this goes up a little more. I think the face came out good. I'm real happy with the face. All right, basta. See you next time. Okay, back to the surgeon painting that I will definitely finish today. It's gone on far too long. And what I have to do is, first, I have to paint the hands. I have to repaint the hand. And then just some little things here and there. I want to do a little bit of work on the mouth. I'm still not happy with that expression. It looks a little too pleasant or kind. I want to look a little more, a little tougher. He needs to look just a little bit tougher, you know. Maybe I can do that, maybe not, who knows. But anyway, also I have to put in the cigarette. That'll be the last thing. I have to add another strap here, you know, excuse me, for the mask. You know, there's a strap here, there's a strap here, there should be another one here. What else? Just a little touch up here and there. The face, also I have to paint the eyebrows. The eyebrows have to be the same color as the hair, so I have to paint that. But I'm going to start with the hand, to repaint the hand. The hand looks okay, it's just, it needs to be punched up just a little bit. Should probably put some shadows in first, maybe I'll do that. I use the cerulean blue and the cadmium red light with a little thinner. There's always a shadow between the joints of the finger, like right here, there. Yeah, I got a little too much thinner in there, but anyway. It's just a little detail, but details are important, you know? Who said it? Genius is in the details. I forget who said that, but it's very true. All right, that's enough. Also, while I'm at it, I have to do the arms. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, what's next? The eyebrows. I got to move the camera. I have to do that first. So the eyebrow, the hair was cadmium red light, and then I rubbed it out a little bit and put in some yellow ochre, right? So that might be a little too much yellow ochre, but yeah, it looks all right. Now, for the mouth. See this, the line of the mouth, a small change in the line of the mouth can completely change the expression of the face, you know? So you never know what you're gonna get. I mean, you know, you, of course, if you want him to look smiling, the mouth goes like this. A frown, the mouth is gonna be turned down. I want more of a neutral, you never know, with a neutral line, with just a straight line across, neither a frown nor a smile, it could go either way. You don't know what you're gonna get till you do it. But also this little corner stroke here is a little too big. I want to get rid of that. So first, I just have to put down some red. Just kind of remove that whole thing and redraw it. See, that looks better already. He looks a little more neutral. He still looks like he's smiling a little bit, but when I redraw that, I might, maybe what I'll do is, yeah, see, that's better. It's a little more, it removes that kind of smile effect a little bit, I think. Anyway, I have to redraw that. Now, also for the philtrum, I wanted to, I put in some highlights and I let them dry and on his left side, you know, because the light source is coming from his right. So that means this side of the philtrum is going to be a highlight and this side is going to be a little bit in shadow. So I put in the highlight, let it dry. Now I'll just put some shadow there and kind of sponge it out a little bit, and maybe I can get what I'm after, which is that little scooped out look. Normally, I don't bother with that, but I thought I might want to do it here. We'll see. I really need my glasses for this, but. All right, so there it is. It's the shadow. It's a little too thin. Well, you get the idea. You know, it's, hold on. It's a little bit too thin. I don't know. That's about the best I can hope for. For some reason, see, I don't want to put any more highlights in because then I have to wait for the whole thing to dry again. I don't want to do that. So, I think right here it needs to be sponged out a little bit. Yeah, that's better. You can kind of get the idea. I have to redraw that one side too. All right, so now, the cigarette. I'll put in the cigarette, right? I'll put in the white first and then I'll redraw it. So maybe I should do a joint instead. Then for the tip, not too bad. And a little yellow. A little bit of yellow over the red. Give it that little flame look. Not too bad. Yeah, that looks good. I have to redraw it too. Also, I have to clean up that underneath the... That looks great. All right, what else? Strap. See, the strap should be white. Then in here, I gotta do a little touch up here and there. I'm gonna bring the ear out a little bit more. Yeah, so a little bit of touch up on the shirt, which was purple, ultramarine blue, and white, I think. See if I can match that color. Oh, not bad. Not bad. In fact, very good. Where else? Well, I think that's it. All I have to do is do a bit of redrawing of certain things here and there. This, I have to clean up that. What color was the background? I have no idea. What the heck color was that? Looks like it's about 9 different colors in there. I'm going to try the raw sienna ultramarine blue combination with a little white. Maybe that'll do it. Oh, that's not too bad. Good enough for, there's an expression, it's good enough for TV. Now there's a new expression, it's good enough for YouTube. All right, now I have to just redraw a bunch of stuff. I'll start with the eyebrows. Yeah, the eyebrows are very important. You know, if the eyebrows, for example, if the eyebrows are going up towards the center of the face, like if they're tilted up from there up upward in that direction and over here, that gives them a like a kind of a quizzical look, amused even. If they're the other thing, if they're going down, if they're angled down towards, you know, the bottom of the face, this way and then this way, then they look angry, you know. So that can always make a difference, what you do with the eyebrows. Of course, he's wearing shades. Oh, also with the shades, I have to put in this. I don't want to forget that. I don't know. I'll just give him kind of a neutral eyebrow. What the heck? Then I have to touch that up a little bit, though. Yeah, this little, the little details towards the end, they're a little too fussy, but I don't like the paint. I'm not a fussy type painter, you know, but it has to be done. At this point in the painting, the most important things have already occurred. And the object now is not to mess them up. That's what you're trying to do now. Just don't mess anything up that already looks good. All right, I have to kind of redraw the straps and the mask, you know, just give a little outline there. I have to do the same thing with the cigarette. I don't want to forget that. I'll do that right now, actually, with the cigarette. And then I just want to try that. Now the mouth. Yeah, that looks better. It doesn't look. Might want to just. Add a little bit here, the upper lip. Yeah, that's good. What else? Oh, I gotta keep the straps. Oh, also, I have to redraw the hand a little bit. Oh, he needs a fingernail there. Is that in the frame? Just barely. What about the saw? The saw looks okay. Maybe Now this doesn't look right. All right. What else? Well, I want to do some touch-up over here. Just along the edge of the hair in here. Fill in those, there's some little blank spots there. I'm not going to match this collar perfectly, but that's okay. It's just these little areas are not too prominent, so I don't have to really match that color exactly. As I've said before, I have a very forgiving style. And it's not by accident. Yeah, well, that's why I like the German Expressionist painters, because they're completely, they're very improvisational, and they kind of paint like a child. They have the attitude of painting like a child, you know, and children are natural painters because they have no fear, you know, they just have a good time. Painting for them is a form of play, and, you know, so when you see that in a real painter, it's nice to see that. A German Expressionist type painter who's been painting for, like Max Beckmann is a good example. Well, they're all, you know, they've been painting for years. They've been painting for 20, 30, 40 years. So they've got all that technique behind them. But the attitude is the same. To have some fun, to make a form, to play. It's a form of play for them. My stuff is a little more, not quite as play. My style is, I try to keep it loose, but I have a tendency to try and tighten things up from time to time, which I'm always resisting, but somehow it's part of me, you know, that tendency to tighten it up just a little bit, you know. Well, that's it. Have I missed anything? The cigarette? I got the cigarette. I might want to touch up that mask a little bit right here. I got to redraw part of his arm just a little bit. Down there. Oh, I gotta sign my name. Jesus, don't forget that. To sign my name. My favorite part. So, where should I sign it? Well, yeah, I usually sign it on some horizontal line, so I'll do it right here. Don't mess up the signature, Jack. I don't have to do this over. Came out good, the signature. That's it. Ready for the museum. There it is. Mickey Roarke is the surgeon. Soon to be shown at your local Cineplex. Don't forget to go see it. Okay, thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't. Give it a thumbs up and leave a comment and all that stuff. Tell your friends all about it, and see you next time.